Have you ever made lemonade, tea, or added sugar to one of your favorite drinks? Did you ever stop to think of why the sugar you added disappeared in water? The reason why sugar seems to disappear is because some substances dissolve in liquids while others do not. In science, we call this solubility. Matter can be classified by its solubility or the ability it has to dissolve in liquids. For example, salt and sugar both dissolve in water because they are both soluble. When sugar is added to your favorite drink and stirred, it dissolves and forms a solution. A solution is formed when a substance dissolves in another substance. Solutions cannot be easily separated. This is because the physical characteristics of a substance change when it dissolves. For example, think of how difficult it would be to separate the sugar in lemonade once it dissolves. It wouldn't be easy. You would have to evaporate all of the water to separate the sugar from the lemonade. The next time you're making lemonade on a hot and sunny day, remember that the sugar you added is soluble because it has the ability to dissolve in water. However, not all objects dissolve in water. Think about sand that is found on a beach. Sand does not dissolve in water because sand is not soluble. Oil, sand, wood, and rocks are all examples of insoluble substances. They do not dissolve when placed in water. They maintain their physical properties. Substances can be classified by their ability to dissolve or not dissolve in a liquid. This helps scientists categorize different substances based on their physical properties. Matter can also be classified by its mass. Mass is the amount of matter in an object and is measured in grams. Some objects have more mass than others. A perfect example is a bowling ball. There is a lot of matter found within a bowling ball. Some objects have less mass, like a soccer ball. Mass does not depend only on the volume of an object, but also on density. Both a bowling ball and a soccer ball have the same volume. They both look like they take up the same amount of space, but a bowling ball has more mass than a soccer ball. That's because the particles in a bowling ball are more compact or packed tightly. In a soccer ball, the interior is mostly air, and air molecules are more spread apart. That means that you can have two objects with the same volume, but with different masses. A balloon filled with air would have less mass than one of the same size filled with water. If we were to compare a beach ball with a bowling ball, the beach ball has greater volume. It appears larger in size and takes up more space, but a bowling ball has greater mass. Always remember that mass depends on not just volume, but also on density. Let's quickly review what we just learned. Matter can be classified by solubility, which is the ability it has to dissolve in a liquid. Some examples of solids that dissolve in water are sugar, salt, and coffee grounds. Some substances that do not dissolve in water are sand, glass, pepper, and rocks. Matter can also be classified by its mass, which is the amount of matter in an object. Some objects have more mass than others. Just because an object is larger doesn't mean it has more mass. Mass does not only depend on volume, but also on density. See you all next time.